Wholesale inflation worsened to 3.1% in January from 2.59% in the previous month. Wholesale food inflation, or the rate of increase in wholesale food prices, softened to 10.12% last month compared with 11.05% in December. This data was released by the government. Earlier, another data showed that retail inflation measured by consumer price index worsened to 7.59% in January. Official data on wholesale inflation gauged by the wholesale price index, or WPI, showed that consumer inflation in January hit the highest level recorded since May 2014, dashing hopes of further monetary easing by the central bank for the time being. The Reserve Bank of India tracks consumer inflation primarily for formulating its monetary policy. The central bank kept the key rates unchanged this month while maintaining the status quo on its accommodative policy stance in its sixth bi-monthly review of current financial year. In 2019, the RBI lowered the repo rate in 5 out of 6 bi-monthly policy reviews to help growth. Now, let's talk about the data which said that retail inflation worsened to 7.59%. The inflation remained above the Reserve Bank of India's medium-term target of 4% for a fourth month in a row, dashing hopes of further monetary easing at a time when economic growth has fallen to the lowest in more than 6 years. Food inflation eased to 13.63% in January from 14.19% in December. The RBI, which cut interest rates by a cumulative 135 basis points last year, is now expected to keep interest rates on hold until late this year, putting the onus on the government to boost the flagging economy. In separate data released by the Indian government, factory output measured by the Index of Industrial Production contracted 0.3% in December. This was worse than the estimates of economists. Experts say that the sharp spike in food inflation has led January CPI to breach a 6-year high of 7.59% compared to 7.35%, which was seen in last December. It is the consecutive second month that CPI has breached the upper band of RBI's inflation target. Index of Industrial Production has unexpectedly contracted to 0.3% in December from 1.8% in November. Like I said earlier, due to higher inflation, RBI has been maintaining a status quo since December 2019. If inflation continues to hover above 6%, RBI cannot be expected to cut interest rates or change its accommodative policy stance. Prices rose faster for fuel and light, which was 3.7% in Jan and 0.7% in December. For miscellaneous, it was 4.8% in Jan and 4.1% in December. Clothing and footwear was at 1.9% in Jan and 1.5% on December. And paan, tobacco and intoxicants were 3.6% in Jan and 3.4% in December. Prices eased for housing, which was 4.2% in Jan and 4.3% in December. Cost of food and beverages increased at a slightly lower rate from 11.8% to 12.2%. Vegetables were 50.2% in Jan and 60.5% in December. Faster increases were seen for cereals, which were 5.3% in Jan and 4.4% in December. Milk was 5.6% in Jan and 4.2% in December. Fruits were 5.8% in Jan and 4.6% in December. Pulses were 16.7% in Jan and 15.4% in December. The food rate slowed to 13.6% from 14.1%, which was the highest since November of 2013. On a monthly basis, consumer prices fell 0.1% after surging 1.2% in December. This is the most since July of 2017. Coming back to Index of Industrial Production, factory output has posted a modest growth of 1.8% in November last year after contracting for three consecutive months of August, September and October. But it again contracted in December after manufacturing sector output saw a dip. The cumulative IIP growth in April to December over the corresponding period of the previous year was 0.5%. The monthly swing in factory output clearly suggests that industrial production is still weak and no signs of stabilization is shown. Electricity generation, which is a barometer for industrial activity, saw a 0.1% drop as against a growth of 4.5% in December 2018. The overall food inflation in January was at 13.63%, slightly lower than 14.19% in the preceding month. The outbreak of the coronavirus in China can adversely impact India as China is one of the largest trading partners. With several factories being closed down in China temporarily, the electronics and auto industry in India will likely be hit because of their dependence on Chinese imports of components and raw materials. India's inflation that has peaked in January will probably ease in coming months, allowing the central bank room to resume interest rate reductions. Data's last week showed that retail inflation surged to 7.6% last month from a year earlier, which was mainly on account of costlier fuel and elevated food prices. The good news is food prices, especially those of vegetables, are coming off the boil, which analysts predict that it will set the course for deceleration in price growth. Inflation will ease to below 6% by March, according to senior economists. Slowing consumer price gains will allow the Reserve Bank of India to keep the door open for more policy easing to boost credit demand in an economy that's on course for its weakest expansion in 11 years. After delivering 135 basis points of cuts in five moves last year, the central bank cited high inflation for pausing in December. With the bulk of those reductions yet to be passed on by banks to their customers, the RBI turned to unconventional policy tools to keep borrowing costs down. The Monetary Policy Committee kept the benchmark interest rate unchanged at a decade low of 5.15%, and the RBI Governor Shaktikanta Das said that there was a policy space available for future action. Interest rate swaps are pricing in the chance of a rate cut in the next 12 months, while economists expect 25 basis points of rate cuts this year. This view is supported by the central bank's forecast that inflation will ease in January to March to 6.5% and further to 5% to 5.4% in the first half of the financial year beginning April 1st. The RBI has a mandate to keep inflation in a range of 2% to 6%. Underlying inflation, which strips out volatile food and petroleum products, is expected to remain muted. While it inched up to 4.2% in January, economists say that was mostly on account of higher telecommunication tariffs amid overall demand remaining subdued. Basically, fundamental drivers of inflation such as sub-potential growth, tighter liquidity, good winter sowing of crops and limited fiscal slippage are weak, and those are the reasons for inflation. But not all is bad about India's inflation index, and these are the reasons. We saw that consumer inflation has risen dramatically in the month of December, and the core inflation is still muted because of subdued demand. This essentially means that once the vegetable prices cool down, the inflation figure will fall back within the comfort zone of the RBI. Another silver lining is that the higher price of farm products will lift rural earnings, which are crucial for an economic revival. Moderately high inflation will lift nominal GDP growth, which is projected at 7.5% for financial year 2020, which is a 42-year low. But on the other hand, household budget will see a higher outgo on food items, which can shrink demand for other products. This is actually a bad news as the overall demand is already down. Another downside is the risk of stagflation. Stagflation is a condition of slow economic growth and relatively high unemployment or economic stagnation accompanied by rising prices. Many economists have started raising the alarm over India entering stagflationary phase with growth stagnating and inflation creeping up. For now, as the inflation has breached the upper end of RBI spectrum, the central bank may not effect a rate cut anytime soon. Recent surveys from the central bank also showed that consumer sentiment has worsened to a near 5-year low, while slack in manufacturing companies widened to its most on record. These data temper any optimism from recent high-frequency indicators such as purchasing manager surveys that showed a pickup in both services and manufacturing sectors. What's uncertain is the timing of any cut by the RBI. A 25 basis point easing could be expected, but not before December. Stay connected to us for more such information. This is Nisha PS.